first question, and Reverend Brown will be answering this question. It says, please tell me what is going on with the hospital that is owned by JFK and any innovative ideas to use to serve the community?
Well, I can tell you what's not going on, and that is a plan for a new hospital, a plan for a full-service health facility. What I have looked into in reference to that hospital is, if I'm mayor, one of the things that we can focus on is looking for a developer. Also, I would check with the New Jersey Redevelopment Authority and see if they could allocate money to see if that is possible, that we can bring a full-service hospital back, and also a health facility that could benefit the residents of Plainfield. What I'm not in favor of is putting any type of residential center there.
Dr. Davis, the Bazy.
Well, this is one of the concerns we have. When decisions are made in closed rooms, and residents of the city not aware of what is really happening. A city like the city of Plainfield should have a full-scale hospital. There's no reason why you shouldn't have one here. For a decision to be made to set out without residents knowing what the decision is the most terrible thing you can have. I am the only one sitting up here who is not in part of the city hall in any form or shape, that I bring now the new blood that is needed for the forward movement of our city. If the people who've been there are not aware of what it takes to make a city to move forward, I am here to serve. If they have failed to serve, I am willing to serve. I cannot do this alone. I will need the help of everyone. I do not have all the answers, but I think coming to the table, we'll be able to do that together. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mann.
Well, as everyone knows, hospitals across the state, across the nation, have been closing, have been consolidating. I inherited a 10-acre site that had been abandoned for the last 8 years, and I embarked immediately on a course of action to return health care services to that campus. We put forward an RFP, and Reverend Brown should know that the process was already undertaken, and that a developer had been identified, and that we will be returning 140,000 square feet of medical services to the Muhlenberg campus. That is a fact. There's a signed agreement between JFK and the developer, and that happened as a result of my proactiveness upon assuming the office of mayor. We are returning healthcare services to the Muhlenberg campus.
The reality of it is there were several individuals who are in office and that are no longer in office who sat on the Muhlenberg board and allowed it to close down. It's not attacking the issue after the fact. You have to address the issue while it's going on. And again, I have to say, as a council member, there is a proposal on the table for a medical block. No, it will not be a full-service hospital. But doing my research, it's hard to bring back a full-service hospital. But there is a proposal on the table, not only under Mayor Mapps, as he said, leadership, but it's also, as everyone knows, advice and consent of the council members.
Please hold your applause so we can just move along with the questions. We try to get as many, there's plenty of questions to be asked here. Okay, so question number two, and we start with Dr. Davis E. Bazy. And the question reads, if elected mayor, what would you do to for more efficient and effective social service programs offered by the city?
I started by saying, you cannot give that which you do not have. In other words, you have to have the knowledge to be able to know where and how to get that which is needed for a city. The people, if you look around, are in need of jobs. have to be able to attract people who are able to come here to invest and so produce a much better city. I see the stop sign, I don't know what else. So we should be able to go out and attract people who have that money and looking for where to go with their money, coming to Plainfield to spend. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Mapp.
We have partnered with a number of organizations such as Home First. We've partnered with the YMCA and a number of social service organizations to make sure that we provide for the people that are here. Because everyone deserves to have the services that they need, and we have done an effective job partnering with social service organizations. I must also add that employment is important to the city, and I am focused on making sure that our people have an opportunity to be gainfully employed. And to that end, we have hosted a number of job fairs at City Hall, and we've been successful in driving unemployment down from a high of almost 14%. When I took office, to a low of 5.4% as of November 2016. We have put 100 of our people to work in full-time jobs at the U.S. Postal Service. And I am very proud of my record of accomplishment. We are putting people to work, and I will continue to focus on making sure that we provide for the social needs of our members here, our residents here in the city of Plainfield.
Thank you. Ms. Rivers.
Social service programs is a must. As serving on the council, there are several council members along with previous council members that want to cut social service programs. We must invest in what we have here. Jobs is extremely important, but everyone can't get a job at the postal office because we do have young men and women out here that have a record. So we have to invest in them also. We can't just invest in the elite. We have to invest in all residents of this city of Plainfield. Again, we have council members and previous council members that sat on the council and want to eliminate social service programs. We have to invest in those social service programs, which are grant funded. They are grant funded, and we have to invest in these residents in this city of Plainfield.
Yes, let me just say very quickly before I ask a question, getting back to the health center. I'm aware that there's a health center that's going to be there, but I was talking about a full-service health center being that. Also, in reference to social service, as you see, my background is in social work. My background is in family and neighborhood counseling. You know, once a social worker for the Division of Youth and Family Services. And, you know, one of the programs that we had in Plainfield was called the Safe Haven Program, and I was the coordinator for that program. It was a program that provided after-school activities for youth. We know that our young people are the unsafest after school. So I had a program, it's called the Safe Haven Program. It was a program that provided tutoring, dinner for young people immediately after school. I'm in favor also of looking at relevant senior citizen services. You know, we have a lot of seniors in our town that do not participate in the senior citizen building. They also have concerns and needs that we need to look at. In terms of social services, I'm able to, I stop already? Okay, all right.
Question number three, we're starting with Mr. Mapp, and the question reads, besides a community center, what other youth community initiatives do you have planned?
It is extremely important that we take care of the needs of our young people. And I believe that wholesome recreational opportunities are important. And one of the things that we're doing, we're investing $1.7 million in transforming Cider Field into a multi-sport turf facility at a cost of $1.7 million. Most of the money is coming from grant funds. We are also making sure that our young people are safe, and many of them are skating in the street, in the roadway, and we are building a park, a skate park, at Madison and 2nd, so that our young people who enjoy the sport of skateboarding are able to go there and be safe.
But we also know how important it is to take care of the needs of our young people and provide job training. We're opening a center called Nantech World 2, where we will be training our young people for jobs in the 21st century, where they will be Cisco certified. So we are focusing on the whole person.
Ms. Rivers.
Our youth, our millennials, are important. It's important that we invest in a full-service community center. Mm-hmm. I did my research. I went to Woodbridge, and I went to New Hunter. And everyone can't skate. A full-service community center consists of investing in the millennials from the youth. We have millennials that are coming home that don't have the jobs. They want to give back to our youth. That's, our youth are lost. See, I had this when I was coming up. I had the neighborhood house, the science center. I had the South Second Youth Center. My mother, I come from a single mother home. And yes, I had a place to go to do my homework. The community center is just not for fun. Mm-hmm. It's about educating our youth, giving them a place to go when they don't have nowhere to go. It's important. And that's why we have so many lost out there on the street. Yes, Safe Haven was a great program that the council got rid of. Thank you.
Thank you. Reverend Brown.
The social, the community center, and what other youth community initiatives you have planned?
Well, as I stated, you know, my background being in counseling, I understand how important it is that our young people have something, some place to go. In a town.